Well into a bright sunny spring, the solar thermal has been repaired with a new control unit. Notwithstanding the news that some councils seem to be scared about people enjoying themselves, it's a stroll along the Ridgeway today. The usual seasonal closure to motor vehicles has been extended into May. The aftermath of a wet winter. A horse training run. Back onto the Ridgeway and back to Hackpen Hill. It's going to be a warm week, so this sheep with a wool on might not like it. Almost no wind today, with a high pressure. So here's the horse. A westbound walk to Wayland Smithy. band back again. Looking east towards Uffington Castle. Nearly midday, quite a few here now. The tree responded well to the bright spring, at least a kilo today after disturbing the fruit. Runner beans are on the way, and not long before the first batch of blackcurrants are ready. Some fruit is about fortnight early because of the weather. A hazy, high-pressure day. While it was here, the temp rose to around 27. Halfway round the castle. Rorton Solar Farm. Panel efficiency deteriorates with higher temperatures. Apparently this happened a couple of days ago when it was wet, otherwise there could have been a major grass fire. On towards Hackpen. Plenty of energy underground, an oil pipeline, no doubt from Fawley Refinery, near Southampton. And back to Barbary. I'm using 60% currants, 40% sugar beet sugar, weight by weight. It'll go into a 0.75 litre jar, probably three of these this year. When the boiling point reaches 107, it'll be ready. And here it is. There were actually three jars of jam so far. The canal route over the Ray. People don't like gates. An alternative path has been created instead. On top of the aquifer. A spot of fly tipping. along the towpath. Like the other end, the gate is not preferred. Late in the morning, and this is a popular place. There was a southwesterly wind, and there were quite a few paragliders over the downs. I climbed to the top, looking back the other way. So it was an anti-clockwise walk. Eastbound along the ridgeway. They were right by the gate, so I had to negotiate with them to get through. Fly tipping. Into Ogbourne St George. The footpath goes through the churchyard. Didn't actually go into the village, but turned back the same way. The cattle had moved from the gate. The sat-nav tried to route me via the road to the left, which is closed for through traffic. Has been for years. Units not stated, but these are imperial. Most footpath signage is metric now. There was a fair bit of drizzle this morning. A dead tree. Still a bit more cutting to do. A strong westerly wind today. No cattle today. It's about an hour before low tide. There was another car behind, so I'm glad that one stopped. It's a 30 zone through Lidington. The cattle were interested in me. As this season's door to a close, what a weird pair they were. Notwithstanding the difficulties, it's been possible to do several walks, some of which are shown here. We've all suffered from dodgy politics, in particular, the effects of a gross overreaction to whatever the original source of the alleged illness was. The events have demonstrated how weak democracy really is, and how vulnerable many people are with regard to diktat, as it were. Those of us who are used to selective reporting and political campaigning techniques are probably not surprised by the activities of the usual suspects. However, some of those who are supposedly apolitical have been sucked in and may end up losing their reputation. We'll see. In particular, the methodology used in relation to infection measurement, how the stats are calculated, and how they are reported should be open to question. For example, they never explain how the definition of infection works. In simple terms, the definition is that any detected virus automatically leads to one related disease, so it goes down as an infection. In some areas, there's been a degree of hyperactive screening for viruses, even on those with no symptoms. That's to say, no noticeable disease, resulting in a spike in infection stats. Not only that, there's not much reporting of the accuracy of the test method in use, so in the real world, most of the reported figures are bollocks.